Yeah, it's been an unbelievable couple days here. So much respect for North Carolina and their program, and to do what we did 2 years ago in the Dean Dome and then come here in Carmichael, where there's so much tradition. It was a really neat environment in here. So loud and so much energy in here, and our guys handled that the right way, which I'm proud about. You know, the first half we had some things go our way and not go our way, but the second half I thought we really buckled down and handled the business we needed to.
And I know you mentioned in the locker room some stats that you like. 5 turnovers to their 11, points off turnovers 15-4. Ball control has been kind of a staple of Wofford, but what about your guys tonight?
Yeah, the last two games I've been proud of our assist to turnover ratio. That's way more Wofford-like, and we had to make up some points some way. So the points off their turnovers kind of neutralized their fast break points and their points off second chance. And for the most part, we did a great job of that in the second half. Only 2 fast break points and I think 10 total second chance points. So I was really proud of that effort.
And really seeing it develop the last few games, a theme of your bench contribution, 24-8, your bench, you're getting contributions from, you know, Isaiah Bigelow, you know, some other redshirt freshmen, some guys stepping in. Talk about the second unit.
Yeah, we got really good players here, and, you know, maybe the one area we don't have a lot of depth is down low, and we had to battle some of that in the first half with foul trouble. But we got a lot of good players that we can throw in and give us a lot of firepower here and there, and a lot of young guys that are getting better and better each day and growing in confidence. That's what the non-conference is for, and hopefully this will springboard some more confidence for our team.
And two key guys you just took in there with you, Storm Murphy, 15 points, Trevor Stumpe, 19 points. Some key plays, you know, grabbing that jump ball, getting out of the double team when they're trying to foul. Those two guys, what they've meant, you know, to the program the last few years.
Yeah, they're winners. They're winners. They lead the way with work ethic, their experience. They breathe that confidence into our team. You know, you come up here, you're like, oh, my gosh, there's so much history here and so much tradition. And those guys kept our young guys calm and kept them believing all week. And, you know, hopefully that continues. And those guys are a huge part of what we do, and I hope they have a great, great rest of the season.
Second win over an AP Top 25 team in the school's history. I think the guys might get a snack.
I think a snack time is definitely overdue here. So we're going to find a good spot and enjoy ourselves on the way back home. We got to get back up here in a couple days, so it's going to be a short celebration.
Well, it was very similar, and I think we took that from that experience, you know, just kind of having the same approach, just, you know, playing as hard as you can for as long as you're out there, and, you know, just the will to get it done. I think we had that again, and the guys saw that in the film that we watched, and we were able to do it again.
Now, you had a stat line that was really across the board. You had 5 assists, you had some rebounds, you had a couple steals, but a couple key plays down the stretch, that jump ball, me and one, and then you dribble out of a double team when they were trying to foul at the end. Just talk about your composure and maybe what you're thinking in those moments.
I think a lot of it comes from doing it last time too. You know, just the confidence, knowing, you know, we've done this before and we've been in this position. You know, even when they made those runs and the place is going crazy, you know, we just got to calm down and stay even keeled. And we were able to do that, and I'm just happy that we were able to pull it off.
The bench has really come alive the last few games, but you're someone that probably has seen these people grow, but in terms of Messiah, Isaiah, David coming in, stepping today, what about that unit that you try to instill in them every day in practice?
You know, I'm always on them, just, you know, trying to, you know, because they're going to be really good players. You know, they're only freshmen, only their first years here. So, yeah, I'm just trying to teach them everything I can and just try to be a great leader for them. But, I mean, I'm so proud of them. They're coming along and playing well, especially these last couple games. And, you know, to do it in this arena, this environment, just really happy for those guys. They're playing so well.
We're going to have Storm on here first or in a second. But what can you talk about his play, especially in the first half? Who's really keeping y'all going?
Yeah, he's Mr. Reliable. You know, I think he's got the second best free three-point in the country before this game and probably after this too. But he's just an everyday guy. You know, I can rely on him. It's crazy I can rely on him to hit 5 threes in a game. Like, I was like a normal game for Stormer. But, you know, I'm just so proud of him because, you know, he works so hard at it and he deserves it. I'm just so happy for him.
Snack time going to be a little sweeter?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's so sweet, but this will be a little sweeter.
Yeah, absolutely. The first win my freshman year was a huge, you know, staple in thinking about this game, you know, leading up to the fact that, you know, we believe we can win, you know, and it's a basketball game. And, yes, UNC is a storied program, but we did it 2 years ago, and we were close last year. So we had a lot of belief, a lot of momentum. All the guys were ready. Coaching staff really prepared us well. So I think that first win was huge for us, just believing that we could definitely do it again.
And you had 15 points in the first half, and the ball wasn't quite falling in the second half, but you still managed to stay in the game, and your teammates always give you credit. Maybe talk about your two halves and what you were just doing.
Yeah, first half, you know, we ran some plays. I got some good screens, some open looks, and pulled those, and those went in. That was great. But second half, like you said, a little cold. You know, the shots weren't really falling. But you know, coach has really been harping on me and on me about defense and other ways I can impact the game and moving the ball and screening well and cutting with purpose and other things that really matter. And so, yeah, as I saw, you know, shots weren't necessarily falling. I had to shift my mindset a little bit to, you know, still be aggressive, try to draw others on me, two on the ball. Other people will be open to pass and kick and get some open looks that way.
Some of those open looks went to Trevor Stumpe. He had 19 points, but he impacted the game like you in other ways. You've been here a few years. You've been working with him. I mean, just talk about what he means to this team.
Yeah, Trevor is, you know, such an important piece to this whole deal, to our team. Such a great leader, leads by example. He's such a pro for our team, such a good mindset coming in every single day. He sets the tone, and it's awesome to play with a guy like that. You know, he was on that team, that winning team, 2 years ago, and he brings a lot to the table, as you see. He can shoot it. You know, he knocks down big shots, big free throws. He can defend. You know, he can defend bigger guys. He's really physical, and he moves the ball well. You know, he's such a dynamic player at that four spot that really, really adds so much to this team.
And the bench has really come alive the last few games. You're getting contributions all throughout the lineup, kind of similar to the team last year. Yep. The second unit, what can you say about those guys coming in?
Yeah, they're so important. You know, they have been doing an unbelievable job. You know, Zay hits threes. Messiah is playing out of his mind. Happy birthday, shout out to him. And Trey. Trey is just playing so great lately. Dave came in today, you know. He's impacting the game in a great way. It's just a whole collective unit. You know, we saw Cole and Leaky Black were out this game, but coaches continue to tell us, you know, it doesn't matter who plays, who we're playing against. It's all about the 15 guys, the guys in our locker room, winning the game together as one.
So we're going to get snack time. You got anything in mind?
I think I'm going to go with the sweet tea and Skittles or sweet tarts. We'll see.